investigates is shining a light on political ads. Last week, we dug into an ad that criticized Democrat Vincent Sheheen, who's running for South Carolina governor.
Tonight, Sheheen's supporters fire back with an attack ad against Republican Governor Nikki Haley. In tonight's Truth Check, WYFF News 4's Tim Waller is putting the ad to the test.
Education levels aren't what they should be.
That's the only time in this 30-second ad you hear an announcer's voice. But it lets you know this ad plans to call into question the state of education under Governor Nikki Haley's watch. Two claims were made in those few short seconds. First, that Governor Nikki Haley has vetoed $110 million for education since 2011. That claim is true. The state newspaper in Columbia reviewed each of the governor's education vetoes in an article published last year. But the newspaper went on to explain the vetoes were made because the governor was against using one-time money, that is, money not budgeted for the next year and the next, to pay for what would be a recurring expense. The second claim is that Haley vetoed $10 million for teacher raises. That is also true, but for the same reason as before. Governor said one-time money was being used. Turns out South Carolina teachers got their raises anyway when the legislature overrode the governor's veto. Have student test scores really dropped? Well, the chart you just saw shows South Carolina 6 places from last in the country when it comes to those test scores. In fact, 4th grade reading scores did drop from 2011 to 2013, so that is true. But the change in scores was so small, the National Assessment of Educational Progress called it insignificant. This graphic shows South Carolina is having one of the lowest graduation rates in the country. While that statement is true, there is more to the story, because it leaves out a very important detail. South Carolina historically has had one of the lowest graduation rates. And last year, the state saw its best ever on-time graduation rate, 77.5%. And it was the largest increase in more than a decade. And the third year in a row, our graduation rates have improved.
In our next Truth Check, the latest ad from Tom Ervin, the independent who's running for South Carolina governor. And be sure to check out the Truth Check section of our website, WYFF4.com, for more details on this and other ads.